He is unguardable, especially in this system. You have to just make him shoot over a hand in his face and hope he misses, because the luxury that he has playing here, and I said this about Kobe Bryant at one time, I said this about a couple other players, but particularly Kobe and him, they're the greatest one-on-one players in the world. But they get to play one-on-one because you couldn't double off of Shaq, and you can't double off of Klay or Steph. So he gets to play one-on-one. In the history of basketball, Michael Jordan and all the other greats, Charles Barkley, and even Shaq, they never got to play one-on-one. No one would ever play them one-on-one. LeBron, no one, well, Toronto did a lot, but most people won't play him one-on-one. So when you're the greatest basketball player in the world, and you get to play one-on-one, and you're the greatest one-on-one player, how easy is life then? That's the most easiest thing to happen in the history of basketball.
And you know, it also makes
that's why it wasn't fair
right.
for him going there. That's why everyone was upset. And that's why I was upset. I was like, man, this guy's got to have not be challenged this anymore, and I'm not going to see him reach another plateau right. as a fan. And that was mad.
What also makes it easy, for example, when I was coming up, 6'9 guard was unheard of. Then Magic Johnson comes out to be guard. This dude is 6'11. 6'11 guard. So, you know, most of the guys that are defending him are 6'7, maybe 6'8. And, you know, Charles always says it's like shooting over a chair. Another thing that also makes it easy, a lot of time he's resting on defense. So somebody at Houston is going to have to go at him. You know, he needs to play both sides of the floor. He just can't be roaming around on defense, blocking shots, pretending to play defense, and then, you know, playing all offense. Now, somebody's going to have to make him work on both ends of the floor.
I 100% agree with you. Your question was, how would you guard him? Number one, he's unguardable. Kenny's right. But Shaq's point, I got to make him work on both ends of the floor. I got to try to beat him up physically. You run a lot of picks at him, a lot of ball movement, body movement, which is something the Rockets don't do. I mean, it's going to be interesting how they match up, because he gets to think about this, Ernie. I don't know who he's going to guard.
A reason, he gets to stand in the corner.
He gets to stand in the corner and just, like, do nothing all night.
And roam around and block shots.
He's going to play like a safety to help on James and Chris, but he don't have to play defense. That's a great advantage to have, whether he guards Tucker or Ariza. I don't see him guarding Capella, but he's going to get the rest half the time of the game.
To the point you made, then most of his concerns, 90% of his concerns, are offensive and not having to work on the defensive end, Shaq.
Oh, 7-foot guard, again, unheard of. Great shooter, great player. I agree with both these guys. Definitely unguardable. You know, you got to make him work on the other end. And, you know, it is unfair. He's on a super team. You know, when you're playing, you know, you can't leave Steph. You can't leave Klay. And if Draymond hit this shot, you can't leave him either. So, you know, it's just unfair.
But the one
you know,
thing
good team for him to be on.
The one thing you can do, the two guys people leave open is Draymond and Iguodala. I think you have to do that, and if those guys beat you, you have to just shake their hand. But they neither one of them are great shooters. They're streaky shooters, they're not great shooters. But I think that you have to say, hey, I'm not going to let Kevin, because he's going to have like a 6'6 guy on him.
But the one thing about Draymond and Iguodala, they're smart enough to pass up shots. They pass up multiple three-point opportunities.
Good point, Kenny.
And they dribble at you and run a pick and roll and hand it back to the person.
That could shoot.
They never overshoot. That's what makes them get 70% of their shots are assisted, because they're a smart basketball team. And when he went to Golden State, it was unfair for the NBA.
We're getting ready to watch the Houston Rockets take the floor here for game one. Shaq, take me between the ears of these guys now. You work for an organization here in which the general manager, Daryl Morey, has said their focus was, how do we beat Golden State? They were obsessed with how to beat Golden State. And now here you are, game one, moments away, and this is what your franchise has been building toward. How do you get it done?
Everyone knows to become a champion, you have to beat a champion. This is what they wanted. This is what everybody wanted. Hopefully the leaders on the team, James Harden, Chris Paul, say, hey, we know what we got to do. Let's just go out, outplay them, You know, let's definitely win these two games. Let's not take this home court advantage thing for granted. Let's just come out and get these two games. We know we can play these guys 2 out of 3 times during the regular season. We beat them. I know it's different, but, you know, we just have to come out, enjoy the crowd, enjoy this moment, and let's beat that ass.
Mike D'Antoni says, look, Golden State has shown that on a big stage, they can perform at a very, very, very high level. We haven't shown that yet. But here's the opportunity, Chip.
Well, Ernie, I think a lot of times when you're in this situation, you just try to do too much. Listen, they got the best record in the NBA. They got a terrific team. There's no secrets at this stage of the year. Everybody's watched a lot of tape. They played these guys 3 times. They've been watching them for the last 6 weeks. There are no secrets. But the game still comes down to simple stuff. I always believe if you win the rebounding battle and the turnover battle, you're going to win the game. Like the 3-point shooting thing, that's a streaky thing. But if you win the rebounding and the turnover battle, those are the 2 most important stats when I look at stuff.
Houston's been a slight negative rebound differential in its first 2 series. Golden State has been a +6. The Rockets, meantime, have committed the fewest number of turnovers on average during the postseason. See if they can continue that against Golden State. We're coming back to Houston after this.